มาณเนี้ยสวยเนี่ยแหละสวยสวย
Okay, these are three key workouts, three key sessions that if you do, you will become a faster 10K runner. And I promise you, if you were to do just these three sessions in rotation, you would become a faster 10K runner in the next 5 to 6 weeks. Session number one, progressive run or progression run. If we work off 50 minutes as your current PB, and you can do the maths for your PB, 50 minutes for 10K is 5 minutes per kilometer, and 5 minutes is easily divisible by 10. 30 seconds times 10 is 5 minutes. So we can play with the pace a little bit there, and you can understand the example. Progression run, what we're gonna do is start 10% slower than our PB shape. So 5 minutes, 30 seconds for the first 3K. The second 3K, 5% slower, so 5 minutes, 15 per kilometer for those middle 3K. Then the final 3K at race pace, at our PB, 50 minutes, 10K PB, so 5 minutes per kilometer. So 5:30 per kilometer, 5:15 per kilometer, and 5 minutes per kilometer. What that's gonna do is enable us to finish fast, and we'll get used to accelerating and changing up in gears and going faster towards the end of the race. It also means that we're spending a lot of time at 3 kilometers at race pace, at 10K, race pace, but also a lot of time very, very closely related, 5% and 10% slower than race pace for a 9K session. So we're not doing the whole thing, 10K, but it's a massive confidence booster. Second session, interval session. And we're not gonna do more than 12 to 15 times 400 meters. And you're gonna keep that as a constant. Do 12 or 15 and keep it as a constant so that you can monitor your progress in speed. Remember, interval training, we can either play with the volume, the total volume, and make the session more difficult. We can play with the individual rep length, make it more difficult or easier. And we can also play with the speed we're running at and make it easier or harder. All those three things impact how hard or how easy the interval session is, but it's also how much we put into it. So if you say to two or three different athletes, I want you to do 12 times 400 meters, that can be the easiest workout in the world, or it can be the hardest workout in the world. Depends how much you put into it. But I always want you to keep 60 seconds rest as a recovery. So 15 times 400 meters with 60 seconds rest in between. And what pace I want you to aim at, again, working off 5 minutes per kilometer, 50 minute PB for 10K, I want you to aim at doing those 20% quicker to begin with. So I want you to aim at getting comfortable 4 minutes per kilometer pace and building that volume. 15 times 400 meters is 6,000 meters. So I want you to begin to get comfortable at running 20% faster than race pace. What that's gonna do for you is build loads of confidence, because when you're going off for the first 4, 5, 6K within your 10K race, that 50 minute pace is now gonna feel much more comfortable because you're getting used to running way faster. It's gonna tap into that speed, it's gonna tap into that speed endurance, and it's gonna boost your lactate threshold. Super important to get right. Within the recoveries, I want you to focus on controlling your breathing. So I want you to focus, when you control your breathing, you're bringing your heart rate from, I was just doing a rep, to, okay, we're doing another rep. And those 60 seconds rest in between should dictate the pace of the intervals. So control the session, work on pacing it, and again, warm up is key. Start with a walk, jog, dynamic stretching, accelerate into the pace that you want to hold for the first couple of reps that you're gonna do, 12 or 15 times 400 meters. I want you to get to a point in the warm-up where you can do 2 times 200 meters at the pace that you wanna hold for the first rep. Don't give yourself anything for free in that session, otherwise you're not gonna gain the same level of supercompensation, the same level of improvement from the session if you're only doing part of it. Don't get to rep three and think, right, now I'm ready to go, and now I feel comfortable, now I feel warmed up. The way to progress on from that session, keep it at 12 to 15 times 400 meters, but increase the speed gradually. And I'm talking like maybe it's 2-3%, maybe it's 5%, depending on your starting point. If you've been doing a lot of speed work, this is going to be easier for you to go into. If you've not been doing any speed work, or if you've been doing very little structure in the past, this is going to be a massive improvement point for you, and you can really tap into that. But let the speed come to you. So what that might look like within 4 to 6 weeks, that those that 4 minute pace that you can hold for 15 times 400 meters becomes 3:45 pace. And what does that do for your PB and your target time for 10K? Number three, tempo run. I want you to start with 20 minutes at your current PB time plus 10 seconds. So 5 minutes per kilometer plus 10 seconds, just 5:10. And I want you to hold that for 20 minutes. Now, if you can already hold it for an entire race of 50 minutes, this should be relatively comfortable for you, but uncomfortable enough so that you're still pushing forward with your training. You're still gaining that improvement. What this is going to do for you is improve your lactate threshold and improve your ability to go at very, very close to race pace for extended periods of time, for those longer segments of 20 minutes. The progression from that is then, okay, let's try to do this for 22 minutes. And then 22 minutes again should feel quite comfortable because you're pushing, but you're not out of control. 24 minutes, 26 minutes, 28 minutes, and get that to 30 minutes. It's a great session, and again, will help you build lots of confidence for you to go fast for your 10K race time, especially when you take into consideration that you're going to be on fresh legs because you will have done a taper. Now, how often do you do these sessions? I would want to be doing them every 3 to 4 days. My week looks very, very simple. Midweek interval session and a weekend long run, ideally Wednesday and Sunday. So if you're building your endurance and stamina, that's an extra session. So this could be one every week. Every Wednesday you do, maybe it's a tempo run, maybe it's intervals, maybe it's that progressive run. Maybe the progressive run is currently your long run and that's a specific long run. To make these happen and to keep the consistency, which is key within distance running, means that you need to also add in recovery runs and easy runs. You need to patch these sessions together with accelerating your recovery, but also becoming more aerobically efficient at going slow, essentially. Moving over the ground really super slow, not pushing it like in a 400 meter rep or in a 3K at your 10K PB pace, but just slowly moving over the ground, heart rate's relatively low, in zone one, zone two, and you're just accelerating your recovery, which is going to mean that you patching the interval session through to the long run, or the interval session through to the progressive long run, helps you to hit each session as hard as you can, so you gain as much improvement from each key session as you possibly can. So stick with the sessions, stay consistent, and realize running or trying to be good at anything, especially something like an endurance pursuit like running, is all about consistency. Not every one you're going to smash out of the park. Some are going to be a 10 out of 10, some are going to be a 6 out of 10, but it's the consistency over the times. Let me know in the comments which of those sessions you're most looking forward to try, or which ones you've tried so far and how it went. And also like and subscribe whenever you can. It really helps the channel. I'm trying to build the best running channel on the internet.